Everybody, my name is Caitlin. Before I start, by show of hands, how many of you have a dog, love dogs, want a dog? Amazing. I have three, so today I'm going to teach you how to make homemade dog treats. Okay. So what you need to make homemade dog treats is whole wheat flour, and before you start using whole wheat flour, make sure that you know your dog's allergies, because some dogs are allergic to wheat. If they are allergic to wheat, you can replace whole wheat flour with rice flour or coconut flour, which I didn't know was a thing, but apparently it is. And milk, baking powder, not baking soda, there's a difference. And peanut butter, you can use any kind of peanut butter. You can use chunky, you can use creamy, you can use all natural, whatever you have in your pantry. And a lot of these ingredients I already had, I didn't have to go and buy any of these, they were already at my house. So the first thing you want to do is preheat your oven to 375 degrees Fahrenheit. And do this first, so that way when you're done with the cookies, you can just pop them in and you don't have to wait for the oven to heat up. The second step, you need two bowls for this. So take your first bowl and you're going to mix together your dry ingredients. You're going to take 2 cups of whole wheat flour and your baking powder, a teaspoon of that, and you're going to sift it together so it's all mixed. And your third step, step three, in a different bowl, you're going to add your peanut butter and a cup of milk. And this is kind of where it gets kind of messy. That's why I didn't want to do it in front of all of you. Is the peanut butter is really thick and the milk is really runny. So it's going to take a little while for it to all get kind of soupy. And that's what you want. You want it to be thin and consistent and not all gloppy like the peanut butter is. Step four, you're going to add your ingredients together. You can add the wet to the dry or the dry to the wet. It doesn't matter. And it gets really, really thick and it gets kind of crumbly, so you might want to use your hands instead of using a spoon the whole time. You could start with that, but it's going to be easier to just go in with your hands. Step five, you're going to flour a surface and you're going to roll out your dough. I recommend using the same flour, obviously, as you used in the dough, so you're not using wheat flour. If your dog is allergic to wheat, just don't do it. And you're going to roll it out to about 1/4 of an inch. I don't really measure that, I just kind of eyeball it. And I just use the palm of my hands just to knead it out and make it all flat. Step seven, this is more for you. The dogs aren't gonna care what they're shaped like, but I like to get fun little cookie cutters and stamp them. And since October, I did pumpkins and cats, and at Christmas time, I'll do like a star or a Christmas tree. And then, you know, you can kind of play with it and have fun with it. Then step eight, you're gonna lightly grease a cookie sheet, and I just use the Crisco butter because it's easy and I don't want to get my hands any more dirty than they already are. And then you're gonna place your cookies, and the dough isn't like regular cookie dough. It's not gonna expand or spread like super far. It's gonna pretty much stay the same size as it is right there. So you can put them pretty close together and it's not gonna make a difference. They're not gonna fall off the pan or whatever. And step nine, you bake it in the oven for 20 minutes. Or until they're golden. And I don't flip them. I know my grandma makes these too, and she flips them halfway through, but it just depends on your oven. So if you make them once and they stay pretty, you know, golden and they're not getting black on one side, then you're good to go and they'll be fine for 20 minutes on one side. And then you're done. You let them cool and you serve them to your fur babies. And my mom and I, we just put them in a plastic bag and we keep them in the fridge for about a week. And the dogs love them. Once you make them, your dogs are going to want them again and again, I promise. My dogs are obsessed with them. I have a picture to show you, my dogs. They all like, beg for them all day long. And they love them, and it's fun for you to make them too. So in conclusion, to make homemade dog treats, you need peanut butter, you need whole wheat flour, you need baking powder, and you need milk. And remember to know your dog's allergies. Make sure that you're not allergic to peanut butter because you don't want to be, you know, touching peanut butter and then not be able to breathe. You can also use cheese if you're allergic to peanut butter, which is a good alternative, and your dogs won't care. They'll eat it either way. And have fun with it and spoil your dogs because that's what they're good for.
When you say use cheese, what kind of cheese?
Shredded cheese.
Shredded cheese works the same. Mm-hmm. And how do you know if you don't know your dog's allergies? Well, you just give it to him and then see?
All that, I guess.
And how long does it take to make? I'm asking because I'm curious to make it.
It takes 10 to 15 minutes to prepare them and then 20 minutes in the oven.
Okay. Awesome. Thank you.